Well, my friends, this Palm Sunday 2021 is the 1 year anniversary to the day of when I recorded my first church service in Hershey with Pastor Jim Smith, our chaplain in Hershey. It's been a whole year of recorded pandemic church services. And I don't think any of us ever could have imagined that this would drag on for a whole year. It's been very difficult, and we've made it so far. That said, my word, it's been a hard year, hasn't it? It's been a long year for everyone, and we've lost over 500,000 Americans to the COVID virus. What a life. What an environment we've been living in for the past year. And one of the challenges we have as Christians is, how do we strike a balance and hold on to our faith during such a year as this? Now, it may be getting a little bit easier now. I think we're seeing light at the end of the tunnel with people being vaccinated already. And they're even talking about opening up some of the restrictions and letting visitors come in. I know for me, Palm Sunday as a kid was one of those times of the year where I felt a lot of hope. I knew that next week would be Easter, and there'd be Easter baskets and candy, and springtime was already here. This is a very positive and upbeat time of the year. I just would want to run right to Easter as a kid, but we have to slow down here. We have to slow down on Palm Sunday. Before we jump right into Easter and spring, we have to slow down and realize that Passion Week is a whole week of scriptures, services, Palm Sunday service. Maundy Thursday celebrated in some churches. Good Friday, I will be filming a Good Friday service with the seven last words of Christ. And of course, next Sunday will be Easter Sunday. Well, I have a saying that I would like to share with you today. It's kind of a strange saying. Voltaire is accredited for using it, and maybe you've heard it. Perfect is the enemy of good. And that is a strange phrase. The sermon title today is Perfect is the enemy of good, unless it is Jesus Christ. And what I wanted to say is this, is that sometimes in life, we have perfectionistic attitudes of how we think everything is supposed to pan out in life. And when things don't pan out the way we want them to, when things don't turn out in the perfect image that we have in our mind, we are disappointed. And then what happens is good things can happen, things can get better, and we don't appreciate it. We have to realize life isn't perfect, and that good is good enough. It doesn't have to be perfect. And the reason why I bring that up is because the Bible is very honest and accurate about human character and about God. And we can see in the Bible that everything isn't perfect in the Bible. Sometimes good things happen to good people. They're rewarded for good behavior, for being obedient. But there are other times when bad things happen to good people. No greater example is that of Jesus in the coming week, where he was without sin and did everything God wanted, and yet he was rejected and falsely tried and executed. What we can see here on Palm Sunday is that this is a time of preparation. Even though we consider this to be the beginning of Holy Week, technically you can see I'm still wearing purple. It's the last Sunday of Lent, a time of preparation. Another one of my favorite sayings is, hope for the best, prepare for the worst, and take what comes. And as we go into Holy Week, we need to hope for the best, which will come at Easter, the hope of the resurrection. We need to prepare for the worst and realize that Good Friday will be the remembrance of the tragic demise of Jesus on the cross. We have to take what comes, which means one day at a time we move through Holy Week. Don't just jump right to Easter. Well, let's talk about our text from Mark today, a classic text that's read on Palm Sunday. Jesus tells his disciples to go into the village, to go ahead and to find a colt, a young donkey that he can ride, and says that if anyone asks them about it, they should just simply say that the Lord is requiring it and that he will return it. They go and they do that. And then he prepares this colt with his disciples. People put coats, cloaks on the donkey for him to ride, and then others go along and ahead, and they put cloaks on the ground. Some put tree branches, or we have the palms here. They put palm fronds on the ground. And they yell out, "Hosanna, blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven." This is a wonderful time. It's rolling out the red carpet for someone who they seem to accept as the coming Messiah, the victor, the king. Now, what's going on here? You know, I've said in many of my sermons that when we read the New Testament, we have to remember that these are mainly Jewish people who knew the history of Judaism and the scriptures. And there were a lot of images here that reminded them of the victory of the Maccabees over the invaders of Israel. And there's also imagery of this donkey from Zechariah. What we see here is that in the Zechariah reading, that this is a story, this is a scripture about a coming king who will be the king of the people of God. Sounds wonderful. And in that scripture, it does have that sort of obscure reference to this person riding a donkey. So when Jesus is riding this donkey, this colt, into Jerusalem, it's giving people some type of an image, at least according to Matthew, that this is the fulfillment of a prophecy of their new king that's coming into the kingdom. Now, in Matthew's text, it's a little bit more clear that this is the coming of the ruler of God's people. We know that this is also important, that he is coming in a humble state, not riding a grand horse or a chariot, but the most humble of all work animals, the donkey. So to sum things up, this imagery of Jesus riding a donkey into Jerusalem is a humbling image, but it's also a grand image of people expecting him to be this awaited king who will liberate them and rule over them. They have great expectations of who this is, which leads us to the part where we can see that these well-wishers were very enthusiastic on Palm Sunday. But where will they be a week from now on Easter Sunday? Are these the same people today on Palm Sunday who are rolling out the red carpet and putting cloaks on the donkey and palms on the ground and singing Hosanna? Are these the same people who 1 week from today on Easter will be yelling, "Crucify him and abandon him at the cross"? Well, the short answer is yes, these are the same people. And what this Palm Sunday story is a reminder of is that we have to be careful. It's a warning to all of us that we can be fickle in seeing and understanding who Jesus Christ is and turning on him, turning against him, if the politics and things don't go our way. Now, in all fairness to these people, between Palm Sunday and Easter Sunday, remember, he went into Jerusalem and he did some things that stirred up the public. He overturned the money changers' tables and made whips of cords and scared away animals and people, and they found that disturbing. He upset the religious leaders. But while this did not fit their image of the perfect king, this was the perfect king that God the Father chose in his Son to bring salvation to the people of Israel and to all who would follow him. Well, as I said at the beginning of the sermon, it's been a year now. It's been a year since I filmed my first TV service. We've been through a lot. And we've been through lockdowns, loss of visitation. We've seen friends and family members die. We've experienced health problems and concerns. People have received vaccines. Some have had reactions to those vaccines. We never We never realized what this would be like. So that old phrase about hope for the best, prepare for the worst, take what comes. Wow. Let's see how we did with that. It was hard to hope for the best because we didn't know what to expect. And it, in some sense, it was impossible for us to prepare for the worst because we never lived through a pandemic again. We did take what came, but it was hard. It was a big test. And even so, I think we have to take a moment right now, and we will do this again on Easter Sunday, and remember all the people we've lost this year, and that they are with the Lord now in heaven. My sermon title, again, is strange. It's that perfect is the enemy of good, unless it's Jesus Christ. We haven't been able to go through this year perfectly. There have been a lot of problems. There's been a lot of imperfect responses, things that didn't go the way that we wanted them to do. And what this adage about perfect is the enemy of good is telling us is that when we expect things to go perfectly in life, that prevents us from seeing many good things that are happening. You see, the secret to a good Christian life is that we follow a perfect God. We follow a perfect God in an imperfect world, even when God's plan doesn't meet our expectations. And that's exactly what happens here with Palm Sunday and the Passion Week with the crowd. They had expectations of how this Savior, this plan of salvation, was going to unfold. And Jesus didn't meet those expectations. He was good. He was better than good. He was perfect. But he didn't match up to the perfect in their own minds. Jesus was the perfect king, and they couldn't see it. Instead of him being powerful and political, he was humble. He sacrificed himself even to the point of death. So how does this all relate to us today, March 28th, Palm Sunday, 2021? Things are starting to turn around finally. After a year, they're starting to turn around. Many of you have been vaccinated. We're starting to open up. And it's going to be easy to want to jump the gun. Just like as kids on Palm Sunday, we were ready for Easter. It's going to be easy to jump the gun and want things to pan out perfectly and quickly. But we have to be patient. We have to be careful that this idea of perfect, the perfect recovery, the perfect opening up in our head, that it doesn't take over and that we take everything one day at a time. There'll be many good things that are and will be happening ahead. And we have to be careful with our perfect expectations. We need to realize that as we go through each day, as things turn the corner, that in Jesus Christ, who is the focal point of Holy Week, that we hope for the best in Jesus Christ. He is there for us so that we can be prepared to deal with the worst. In Jesus Christ, we have someone who is there to help us accept things as it comes, even when it doesn't meet our expectations. And so for this reason, I just want all of you to remember that, as we often say at Christmas, that Jesus is the reason of the season, that Jesus is the perfect focus to help us prepare for Holy Week and understand the most important good news of all the good news, which will be Resurrection Sunday. Jesus will travel with us this week. We will travel with Jesus this week and rediscover who he is and what he went through for our salvation. We will realize that while in our human life and our human minds that perfect can be the enemy of good, that with Jesus Christ, he is perfect. He is perfectly good. And if we follow him, we will be on the path that God has for all of us, even when things don't meet our expectations. Amen.